Hello, my beautiful fragrance family. Dustin here, fragrance fan. Go ahead and do me a solid and click that like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to hit that bell notification. And I'm just going to keep on bringing you guys these budget-friendly fragrance reviews. That 40-ish and $100 range, most of these way less than that. And a good number of these you can find at your local rack stores. I'm trying to hurry up and do this video because it is blowing hard outside right now and the lights have flickered on and off several times. So I want to get this thing out before the power shuts off altogether from the hurricane. So I want to talk about two La Taffa fragrances in the midst of their huge collection that they have. They have hundreds of fragrances, two of them that really, really deserve being mentioned because I think they get overlooked, but they are quite nice for what they are. First up, let's go ahead and go with Ragba for Men. So basically, this is a green, grassy, spicy, citrus floral with a little bit of a woody edge going on to it. It's basically Creed's Green Irish Tweed. That's basically what this is. I mean, I'm pretty positive that's what they're cloning, but it's just a little bit more of a spicy take on it. It has all that fresh cut green grass. The green grass that's like in this thing, that's not a specific note, but the accord that I get is kind of more of a dirty, like lawn grass that had been sitting maybe for a day in the sun, whereas Green Irish Tweed is like a fresh cut grass. This is still fresh cut, but seems like it's been baking in the sun for a little bit. Regardless, that doesn't mean that it's bad. It's a very good take on Green Irish Tweed, in my opinion. Train Away from Armoff is the one that gets all the love. It doesn't have as much of the spiciness. It's probably a little bit more accurate, but this thing has its own little twist, that own little Middle Eastern twist that's going on, making it unique. Still redundant to own both, but making it unique and still a good fragrance nonetheless. I lost my Train Away bottle. Lost it. I really liked it. So I ordered this one just to see, you know? And there's no need for me to order Train Away now because I have this. It'll be redundant. I don't need it. So, good smelling fragrance. Projection, about average longevity, right around that 5 hour mark. So it's nothing crazy, but it works. By the way, this is a springtime, summer, daytime, casual, mature kind of fragrance because it's cloning a very old school fragrance. Up next, one that you might have never even heard of before. How do you pronounce this? Malik Al Tayor Concentrated. This one is a fruity bergamot, sweet pineapple, fresh, spicy sage kind of combination. There's also a regular apple in the top of this thing, and I think that's giving it some of the sweetness, but it utilizes that same kind of pineapple that you get in Cadao Frisson, just toned way back, because there's a good dose of citrus and that sweet apple, sweet tart green apple. And that fresh spiciness, it's just a very universal, easy, just kind of a fragrance that you can dumb reach for. It's not just a summertime fragrance. I think this will go good in the spring and the fall, but I think it works better in the summer because it has a lot of fresh elements to it. It's very affordable. When I picked this thing up, I probably picked it up for like $21 or something on Amazon. I didn't look up to see what it is right now, but I'm pretty sure that it is quite affordable. My atomizer cap came apart like that too, so that's to be noted. And the way that the presentation is on this, it's like almost like a rubbery kind of texture. So Malik Al Tayor deserves to be mentioned. There's almost a hint of like a minty thing and a hint of violet leaf. I forget what the notes are in here, but if there's not violet leaf, I'll be surprised, because on top of that fruity pineapple, citrus, spicy thing, there's like florals and like a violet leaf kind of accord, like a little bit of that going on. Really nice fragrance for what it is. Is it groundbreaking and just like a wow kind of fragrance? No. To be honest, what I'll give these ones, this is a 6.5 out of 10. This is a 6.5 out of 10, which is really good on my scale. It's not like a 7 out of 10 is a gem. They're tiptoeing in the gem territory, but they're not quite there. This thing could just about be a gem though. It really could, in all fairness. If it performed another, I don't know, half hour or an hour, it definitely would be. But regardless, these two fragrances, I think, just get overlooked just because La Taffa has so many fragrances that are like wow factor, you know, eternal oud, wow factor type thing, you know? These ones are, wow, that's pretty good, but it's not like, wow, that's really good. So that's why they get overlooked. But regardless, if you're itching to buy a fragrance, this one is probably the most versatile. Whereas this one right here is just good, daytime, casual, somewhat business kind of fragrance, freshy. So just real quick, wanted to put this video out and get straight to the point on these two fragrances. Decent, inexpensive, crowd pleasing, compliment getting, not too bad in the performance. And like I said, Malik Altior, quite versatile. It's a little bit more playful with that sweetness and that fruity thing, but I'm gonna go before my power flickers on and off again. I got lucky so far. So with that, I'm out. Y'all be blessed. Take care of yourself always. And until next time.